A large body of work has documented and attempted to explain the gap in men and women's labor market outcomes. One manifestation of this gap is that, across many different industries, women tend to be promoted at lower rates than their male counterparts. This paper explores one possible explanation for this disparate treatment, namely that a person's gender may influence the way we interpret information about his or her ability. If present, this kind of gender-based asymmetry can have a substantial impact on consequential decisions such as hiring, firing, or promotions, because employers often use information that is subjective or imprecise as the basis for evaluation. To the extent that an employee's gender influences the way an employer views his or her performance, the employer may end up with different beliefs about a man and a woman's ability, even if their objective performance is actually the same. This paper examines this question in the context of medical referrals. The author studies cases where a doctor refers a patient to a surgical specialist and asks two questions. First, is a doctor less likely to refer future patients to the same surgeon if the patient dies as a result of the operation? And second, does their reaction differ based on the surgeon's gender? Now, there are three reasons why this setting is particularly well suited to studying the broader question of whether gender plays a role in shaping our beliefs about others. First, medical research suggests that doctors send more referrals to surgeons who they believe to be of higher ability. This means that the author can use the volume of a doctor's referrals to a surgeon as an observable proxy for something that is ultimately unobservable, namely the doctor's beliefs about that particular surgeon. Second, the high frequency of referral decisions makes it possible to document how doctors react to individual signals, such as a patient death. This is difficult to do in many other work contexts, where the observable action, such as a promotion, is relatively infrequent. And finally, in this setting, the author has access to detailed Medicare data, which allow her to implement a matching strategy. For each observation in her data where a female surgeon performs a given procedure, the author matches this to a corresponding observation where a male surgeon performs the same procedure on a similar patient with similar observable characteristics and the same outcome results, for example, a patient death. The question is whether the fact that the performing surgeon is male or female has any meaningful effect on how the referring doctor reacts to this event. By controlling for all other observable characteristics of the situation, including the surgeon's training and background and the relative riskiness of the patient and procedure in question, the author argues that she can plausibly isolate the portion of the doctor's reaction that is solely attributable to the surgeon's gender. This matching strategy yields a sample consisting of over 7,700 matches for bad surgical events, that is, cases in which a patient dies, and nearly 7,000 matches for unexpectedly good surgical outcomes, namely an unanticipated survival. Using these matched male-female pairs, the author shows that doctors do appear to interpret surgical outcomes differently depending on the gender of the performing surgeon. In particular, her analysis reveals two asymmetries. First is an individual-level asymmetry. This figure shows how quarterly referrals to the surgeon are affected if a patient dies as the result of an operation. For male surgeons, referrals dip slightly immediately following the death, but appear to recover thereafter. Female surgeons, however, experience a sharper and much more persistent decline in referrals than do their observably similar male colleagues. Note that, prior to the patient death, referral patterns for male and female surgeons are actually very similar, and this divergence only appears after the negative patient outcome. This individual-level asymmetry is also apparent in how surgeons are rewarded for unexpectedly good outcomes. After such an event, referrals increase for both male and female surgeons, but by a greater margin for males. In terms of magnitudes, following a patient death, doctor referrals drop by 34% when the surgeon is female, compared with only a slight stagnation for male surgeons. In essence, women are punished for one mistake in the same way that men are punished for three. Following an unexpectedly good outcome, referrals double if the surgeon is male, but increase by only 70% if the surgeon is female. In addition to this individual-level asymmetry, the author also uncovers a group-level asymmetry. Following a negative event with one female surgeon, doctors not only reduce referrals to that individual, they also become less likely to refer to other female surgeons. In contrast, a negative event with one male surgeon does not affect doctors' behavior toward other male surgeons. Thus, while a single woman's performance is apparently used as the basis for updating beliefs about the ability of female surgeons as a group, male surgeons are treated as individuals, and updating beliefs about one male surgeon does not impact the doctor's beliefs about the ability of other male surgeons. These results suggest that surgeon gender systematically influences the way referring doctors interpret information about patient outcomes, and that these asymmetries affect how doctors update their beliefs about surgeon ability at both the individual and group levels. The author does find that certain factors appear to reduce the extent of asymmetric updating. Doctors react less strongly to individual events and treat male and female surgeons more equally the longer their referral history with a particular surgeon is, and if they have had more experience working with female surgeons in the past. Expanding beyond the medical context, this paper argues that gender-based asymmetric updating may partially explain broader patterns of labor market inequality. To the extent that employers form different beliefs about a man and a woman's ability, individual employees can end up on very different career tracks, despite having the same objective performance. To explore more on this topic, you can check out the full paper, as well as its references to other related research. These include papers on the gender wage gap, research on discrimination, both from a theoretical and an empirical point of view, and related work from the behavioral and social psychology literature on biased updating.